Hi viewers, this is Meenakshi from Max Teacher. Welcome to my channel. You are watching Gunit Tutor MS. Are you ready to learn? Let me start the class. In this video, I am going to solve the problem. Exercise 3.5, fourth problem, subdivision number 1, chapter 3, 10th standard. Actually, what we given in this problem? Form the pair of linear equations in the following problem and find the solution within the bracket they set if they exist by any algebraic method. Clear? Actually, they given a situation. Now we can use this situation to form a pair of linear equations in two variable. Then we can solve this pair of linear equation if the solution is exist. Clear? And also we can use any algebraic method. Actually, we know the algebraic method, that is substitution method and elimination method, as well as cross multiplication method. So in this three method, you can use any method to solve the value if the solution is exist. Clear? Here the first problem. A part of monthly hostel charge is fixed and the remaining depends on the number of days one has taken food in the mess. Are you clear? I can read the first line. A part of monthly hostel charge, actually a part of monthly hostel charge is fixed. So monthly hostel charge is fixed one, that is a fixed one, and remaining depends on the number of days one has taken food in the mess. When a student A take food for 20 days, she has to pay 1000 rupees as a hostel charge, whereas a student B, actually student A takes a food for 20 days. Actually, she took 20 days food and she has to pay 1000. Actually, the total charge of the hostel is rent plus food charge. Clear? The rent is fixed one, then the food charges depends upon the number of days. Clear? Next, so first one is 1000 rupees, second one, whereas a student B who takes food for 26 days, here is the 26 days, right? So pays rupees 1180 as a hostel charge. Clear? Actually, the hostel charge is rent plus food charge. Clear? Hostel charge is rent plus food charge. Find the fixed charges and the cost of food per day. Clear? Any doubt? As I already said, the total charge of the hostel is fixed charge, that is a rent plus food charge, right? So the first condition, now we don't know what is a fixed charge, that is a rent of the hostel. So we can take it as this one as a x. So here I just take it as a, let x be a hostel fixed charge, that means rent, and y be the cost of food per day. Clear? So now the first condition, according to the problem, first students A take a food for 20 days and she has paid rupees 1000. So 20 days. So first one is for student A, that is a hostel charge x plus 20 days food. So per day food is, we take it as a y here. So 20 days, so 20 into y, and she has to pay rupees, she paid rupees 1000. Clear? Any doubt? So now x plus 20y is equal to rupees 1000, equation number 1. Actually, it is for student A. Clear? Next is student B. Clear? So student B, now here B for food 26 days, right? Actually, for food 26 days, she paid 1180. So that means x plus how many days? 26 days. So 26 into y equal to 1180 rupees. Clear? So next step, x plus 26y equal to 1180 minus equation number 2. Clear? Any doubt? Clear? Now we find out the pair of linear equations. Now we can solve this pair of linear equation by any algebraic method. Clear? I hope we already well versed in elimination method and substitution method. So in this chapter, we can go with cross multiplication method. Clear? So before we enter to the cross multiplication method, we can rearrange the terms. Left hand side only the variables and constant, right hand should be only 0, right? So we can rearrange the terms in this equation. So from equation number 1, actually here they given x plus 20y. Now we can bring that 100 to left hand side. So it is a plus 1000. So now here minus 1000 rupees. Clear? Equal to 0. Clear? Next, equation number 2. Here, x plus 26y minus 1180 equal to 0. Clear? Any doubt? Clear? So now we can use the first step of cross multiplication method. The first step is we can write the coefficients of coefficients and constant, that is a1, b1, c1, and we can repeat the same thing, a1, b1, c1. The same thing here you can write. The coefficient of x is a1, here 1. So 1, 20 minus 1000, repeat the same thing. So 1, 20 minus 1000. Clear? Any doubt? So second one, second equation. So here also a2, b2, c2, right? So a2 is 1, 26, c2 value 1180, that is 1080. Repeat the same thing. So 1, 26 minus 1180. Clear? Clear? Any doubt? So now we can cancel the first row as well as the second one. Last one. So now x, y, 1. So in between the two rows, we can write x, y, 1. Clear? Now, first step, we completed. So next, from this, we can write x divided by cross multiplication. Right? So 20 into minus 1180. Then minus 26 into minus 1000 equal to y divided by cross multiplication. Minus 1000 into 1, then minus of 1180 into 1, clear? Then which is equal to 1 divided by cross multiplication, 1 into 26 minus cross multiplication, 1 into 20, clear? Any doubt? Clear? Next step. X divided by, now we can multiply. So plus 20 minus 1180. So plus into minus 2 into the whole term, it became a 20 into 1180. So we can multiply the 0. So 23,600, right? So 200, 28 is 16, remaining 1. So 1 to the 2, 2 plus 1, 3. So 1 to the 2. So minus 23,600 minus next 26,000 into minus 1000, sorry, 26 into minus 1000. So minus 26,000. Clear? It is equal to y divided by minus 1000 into 1. So minus 1000. So minus 1180 into 1. Minus 1180 equal to 1 divided by 1 into 26. 26 minus 1 into 20. 20. Clear? Now, next step, x divided by minus 23,600, here minus into minus plus, so plus 26,000 equal to y divided by minus 1000 plus in, minus into minus plus, so 1180 equal to 1 divided by 26 minus 20. Clear? Now here is a different sign, so we can subtract it and put a larger number sign. So here larger number is 26,000. So when I subtract these two, I can get here 2400 equal to here y divided by minus 1000 plus 1180. So 1000 cancel, so remaining 180, that is larger number sign, that is plus, equal to 1 by 26 minus 20, it became a 6. Clear? Next, actual cross multiplication, you can take this two and this first term and last term, second term and last term. So x divided by 2400 equal to 1 by 6. Next to y divided by 180 equal to 1 by 6. Clear? Any doubt? Next is cross multiplications. X into 6. So x into 6, 6x. 1 into 2400. So 1 into 2400, 2400. Next, x is equal to 2400 divided by 6. Now we can cancel it. 1 6 are 6. Next, 4 6 are 24. So remaining 400. So x is equal to 400. So now we find out the x value. Next, here y. So y into 6, 6y. Cross multiplication equal to 1 into 180, 180. Y is equal to 180 divided by 6. Y equal to 1 6 are 6, 2 6 are 12, 3 6 are. So 3 0. So 30. Clear? So we find out a y value also. Clear? So the fixed charge of the hostel is 400. Then per day cost of food is 30 rupees. Clear? Hence we find out the hostel fixed charge, that means rent. We find out that is 400 rupees. Cost of food per day, that is 30 rupees. Clear? We find out. Clear? Any doubt? If you want to do the... I hope in this video you may clear up the problem. Thank you for watching my video. If it is any doubt, you can ask me in a comment. Here I will enclose a few problems for practice. You can practice the problem. While practicing the problem, if any doubt, you just ask me in that comment. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you all of you.